Hey head squeezers, Huw James here. I'm currently on the flanks of Mount Etna on a field trip to find out all about the science of an active volcano. And whilst I was here just for the live experiment strand, I thought we'd find out some different ways to find north using non-conventional methods when you're out and about. So I've got a few different ideas here, but if you don't want to watch them all, then you can follow these buttons. If you want to watch it on a desktop or a laptop, then make sure your annotations are switched on. If you'd like to see me make your very own compass, or you can make one for yourselves, click on this link here. If you would like to see how to find north using the sun and an analogue watch, then you click this button here. And if you'd like to see how we find east and west and all the cardinal points using a walking pole or a stick with the sun, then click on this button here. If you watch on a mobile device and don't have annotations, we've got you sorted. Just watch it all the way through, all right? So pick one. What are you waiting for? You can choose either the analog watch method, make your own compass, or the walking poles. Your choice. So one of the classic ways of finding north that I always show everyone, because I actually believe this is quite cool, is with one of these. It's with a needle. And in my mountain kit, in my first aid kit, I always carry a sewing needle for sewing up whatever, even if it's clothes or skin or whatever. You'll have one of these needles, and all you need to do to find north is to magnetize it. And you can do it with some clothing, or if you happen to have a magnet, like I do, then you can definitely do it with a magnet. And the way to magnetize it is to always push the magnet in the same direction. So you're always pushing that in the same direction. So I'll push this way, and that aligns all the electrons inside this needle to make it magnetic in a particular direction. So it should point south to north in that kind of direction. I'm curious as to whether this one's going to work today, because we're currently on Mount Etna, and everywhere I seem to sit, we've actually moved on to this little bit here, because everywhere seems to be that little bit magnetic. So we have rocks all around that are just little magnets. So you're gonna put it in this little container. You can do it in a puddle or wherever you like, but it has to float on something. I'm gonna use a leaf that I pulled off a nearby bush. And if I put the leaf in, just ever so slightly, and then the needle on top of it, what it should do is twizzle around to face the south-north part of it. And we can actually see now that this is actually aligned. So I've got my compass, and if I place that on the Tupperware box as well, you see that north is directly behind me, south is directly towards you guys. So we have made our very own compass just from a needle and a magnet, and it's a great way of finding north. Now, we don't really use analog watches that much anymore. In fact, I know some people who don't even know what an analog watch is. It's one of these. It's one of the ones with an hour hand and a minute hand on it as well. And we can actually use that as a compass for finding north. My normal watch I take out into the mountains has a compass built into it, but all I need is one of these and to be able to see the sun. In fact, the sun is just now setting behind Mount Etna, because we are on an active volcano. It's quite big, and the sun setting behind there. But to be able to find north, all I need is a line of sight to the sun and my analog watch. So what I'll do is I'll marry up the hour hand of the watch to the sun, which is actually about there. The hour hand now is pointing at the sun, and the 12 o'clock arrow is pointing over in that direction towards that little cinder cone over there. And halfway between 12 o'clock and where the hour hand is south. So that'll be somewhere in that direction. And if I get my trusty compass out and find out which way is north, south, east, and west, we know north is that way, east, south is that way, exactly like our analog watch said, and west is that way. So cardinal points from an analog watch to find out where you are. So one of the ways you can find north which is a really easy method and one that you can definitely try out for yourselves, is using a stick, or a couple of sticks actually. I normally go trekking with my my walking poles as well, so I normally use one of these for this method. And all it is sticking a stick in the ground. It seems quite easy, right? But you stick a stick in the ground to be able to find east and west. So if we put a stick in the ground just here, it casts a shadow, and that shadow goes off in that direction. You can see me and the shadow and the stick. And if I get a rock and put that stick on that shadow, say this rock just here, nice big rock, I put it on that shadow. After a while, because the sun moves across the sky, or actually because we rotate as the Earth, the sun moves across the sky and that shadow will start to move. So it starts off on that shadow, and after time, it'll start to move across this way. And what we do then is put another rock in the place where it's turned out to move. You wait half an hour or so, and then in between those two rocks then is east and west. So to find your cardinal points, which way is north, which way is south, and east and west, then all you need is a stick and a couple of rocks. So there you go, three different ways of finding north without the conventional compass methods. And if you liked it, why not give us a thumbs up, or you can even subscribe to the Head Squeeze channel as well. You may as well do. I'm on an active volcano and I'm loving Head Squeeze right now anyway.